We're making excellent progress. Which way next?
Welcome to my humble home. It's quite a lovely place. To enter, pick the proper letter to fill the empty space.
Which letter do I choose to spell the word for this picture?
Here's a door, ring the bell, see the word, time to spell. You got a word and the word has a missing space. You need to put the right letter into place. How do you know which letter it should be? Well, why don't you try all three? Say fit, bat, bed, or sick, sack, sock. Fesh, fash, fish, or fix, fox, fox. Say them out loud and you will see what the right letter ought to be. Use your ears and you can tell. That's how you learn to spell.
B-O-X spells box. Brilliant, my friend. Please do come in. Greetings, Reader Rabbit. Do come in.
Professor Owl, the scripts you wrote for the show tonight are gone.
Heavens, that means there's no show. But the comedy routine I was going to do with my big cream pie, now no one will get to see it.
We still have time to rewrite those scripts if we hurry. Can you remember what you wrote?
Yes, possibly. But I do need help with the writing over here. And I also need your help coaching Penelope for the play over here. She needs a lot of work.
I'm ready. We don't have much time, so let's get going.
Penelope, how are we ever going to get you ready for our stage act?
Professor Owl is such a worrywart. I can say my words. All I need is a little help.
Penelope, you simply are not ready for the play tonight. Your pronunciation is atrocious.
Yeah, and it isn't very good either. I just need more practice. With your help, I'll be ready for my part in the play. When Professor Owl says a word, pick the cracker with the same beginning sound.
Say the word skunk.
Skunk.
Magnificent!
Thank you.
Here's the next word. Chair.
Chair.
That's it!
Oh, thank you.
And the next word is there.
There.
Well done.
Thank you.
And now, star.
Star.
Yes, that's perfect.
Oh, thank you.
Excellent job, Penelope. Here's a little something for our comedy routine tonight.
Oh, how does it work?
Ah, yes. Let's save it for tonight, shall we?
Remember, when Professor Owl says a word, click on the letters that have the same sound as the ending of the word.
Say the word crisp.
Crisp.
Right!
Thank you.
Here's the next word. Desk.
Desk.
Excellent!
Oh, thank you.
And the next word is cloth.
Cloth.
Magnificent!
Thank you.
And now, much.
Much.
That's it!
Oh, thank you.
Well done, Penelope. What do you think of this prop?
Oh, this?
Yes, that. Do be careful, will you?
Listen to the middle of the word and click on the letters that make that sound.
Say the word teaspoon.
Teaspoon.
Well done!
Thank you.
Here's the next word. Yardstick.
Yardstick.
Right!
Oh, thank you.
And the next word is mother.
Mother.
Oh, capital!
Thank you.
And now, richest.
Richest.
Excellent!
Oh, thank you.
We're making superb progress. Here's something else we might use tonight.
Oh, let me see.
Say the word teaspoon.
Teaspoon.
Oh, outstanding!
Thank you.
Here's the next word. Yardstick.
Yardstick.
That's it!
Oh, thank you.
And the next word is sunshine.
Sunshine.
Right!
Thank you.
And now, weather.
Weather.
Magnificent!
Oh, thank you.
Oh, wonderful! Now look at this. Can you guess how it works? That's it!
Ha-ha! 4 hours have gone by, and they only have part of what they need. They'll never get it all by tonight. I'll show them!
We have everything we need from here. Let's check the list to see what we still need.
Say the word whisper. My goodness, we're almost done! The scripts are almost done, but I need you to help me finish the last few sentences. Here's the list of words I think we should use, but I'm not sure where they go. Choose a word that completes the sentence. Then drag the word to the blank where it belongs. Click on a sentence to hear it read aloud.
Fun. Fun.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Taste.
Right!
This camp is no fun, says Spike. There's nothing to do here.
Let's go fish in the river, says Matt.
Yuck! Fish are smelly, says Spike. But fish taste good, says Matt. I don't know how to fish, says Spike.
Bugs.
That's it!
Lost.
A fine word for this sentence.
I know, says Matt. We can take a hike in the woods. Yuck! There are too many bugs, says Spike. But bugs are neat to watch, says Matt. I would get lost, says Spike.
No.
I say, what a good word to use.
Water.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
I know, says Matt. We can swim in the lake.
Yuck! The water is too cold, says Spike.
But the sun will keep us warm, says Matt.
The water is too deep, says Spike.
Campfire.
A very proper choice of a word.
Together.
Right!
I know, says Matt. We can sing around the campfire.
Yuck! I don't know the songs, says Spike.
I don't know them either, says Matt. But we can learn them together.
What a great idea, says Spike. I'm glad you thought of it.
Oh, thank you, Rita. This should help Charlie and the cast with final rehearsals.
Where?
That's it!
Beach.
I say, what a good word to use.
Matt stands on the beach. The sand goes on and on. Where does the beach end? Asks Matt. I will find the end of the beach. Matt walks along the beach. Ocean.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Answer.
A fine word for this sentence.
She meets a crab. Do you know where the beach ends? Matt asks. The crab walks to the ocean. That crab does not know, says Matt. I wonder who knows the answer. She walks farther down the beach. You.
Right!
That.
That's it!
She meets a sea otter. Do you know where the beach ends? Matt asks. The sea otter runs to the water. That sea otter does not know, says Matt. I wonder who knows the answer. Thinks.
I say, what a good word to use.
No.
A very proper choice of a word.
Matt sits down and thinks. I know where the beach ends, she says. The beach ends where the water begins. Matt runs down to the end of the beach. She plays in the ocean.
Oh, that's it! We've got another one!
Keep.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Lands.
Right!
Matt walks in the desert. The desert is hot. A straw hat helps Matt keep cool. A roadrunner lands on the hat. Hey, why are you on my hat? Says Matt. I need a new home, says the roadrunner. Your hat is my new home. Home.
A fine word for this sentence.
Have.
That's it!
You cannot stay on my hat, says Matt. I will help you find a home. Matt sees a desert tortoise. Can you live in a shell like a tortoise? Asks Matt.
I do not have a shell, says the roadrunner.
Your hat is my new home. Live.
A very proper choice of a word.
Find.
I say, what a good word to use.
You cannot stay on my hat, says Matt. I will help you find a home. Matt sees a kangaroo rat. Can you live in a hole like a kangaroo rat? Asks Matt.
I cannot dig a hole, says the roadrunner.
Your hat is my new home. Sticks.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Cactus.
Right!
You cannot stay on my hat, says Matt. I will help you find a home. Matt sees some sticks on a cactus. Can you live in a nest on a cactus? Asks Matt.
I can live in a nest, says the roadrunner. Your hat is my old home. This cactus is my new home.
Another excellent story. Good work.
How?
That's it!
Start.
A fine word for this sentence.
Princess Babs sits next to her castle. Sir Lunchalot arrives at the castle.
How are you doing, Princess? Asks Sir Lunchalot.
I lost my key,
says Princess Babs.
Do you want to help me find it?
Where should we start? Asks Sir Lunchalot.
Dropped.
A very proper choice of a word.
Scare.
I say, what a good word to use.
I think I dropped the key in the forest,
says Princess Babs.
The forest? We won't be able to find it in there, says Sir Lunchalot.
Don't be silly, says Princess Babs. Together, we will find the key.
And the dragon won't scare us at all.
Dragon? Says Sir Lunchalot.
From.
Right!
Force.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Suddenly, the dragon comes out from the forest. Sir Lunchalot sees the dragon. He becomes scared.
Is the door really locked?
Asks Sir Lunchalot.
It sure is, says Princess Babs. Maybe you can force it open,
asks Sir Lunchalot. Princess Babs tries the door. Walks.
That's it!
Breaks.
A very proper choice of a word.
The dragon walks closer and closer. Sir Lunchalot is really scared now. He runs towards the door.
Oh!
He yells and breaks the door down. The dragon walks up to Princess Babs.
I think you lost your keys, says the dragon.
Well done, reader. I must say that makes a fine story for the show.
Tick-tock, tick-tock, the clock is running, and they can't stop it! Soon, I'll show them who the real star is!
Swim.
I say, what a good word to use!
Arms.
Right!
Baby Bear and Papa Bear swim at the beach. Papa Bear sits on a raft. Baby Bear puts on a mask and fins.
I see an animal with eight arms, says Papa Bear.
Baby Bear dives into the water. She finds an animal with eight arms. It is an octopus, yells Baby Bear. Swims.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
See.
That's it!
I see an animal that is purple and round, says Papa Bear. Can you find it?
Baby Bear takes a big breath. She swims to the ocean bottom. She finds a purple, round snail. Look, Papa Bear, it's a sea snail, says Baby Bear. Seas.
A fine word for this sentence.
On.
I say, what a good word to use.
Now try to find an animal with five arms, says Papa Bear.
Baby Bear looks through her mask. She sees an animal with five arms. It's a sea star, says Baby Bear, but it's stuck on the rock. Lobster.
Right!
Poked.
A very proper choice of a word.
Now it's your turn, says Baby Bear. I see an animal with a shell and claws. Papa Bear looks into the water.
I do not see it, says Papa Bear.
It's a lobster, says Baby Bear. And it just poked a hole in your raft.
Help!
Yells Papa Bear.
Yes! Brilliant! Brilliant! Another script ready to go!
Camp.
That's it!
Fish. Woods.
Ice.
Eye.
Right!
Swim.
Excellent!
Cold. Songs.
A very proper.
Great.
Thank you, reader. Those were some well-chosen words for the story. Just a couple more stories and we'll have all our scripts ready.
Swing.
Right!
In.
A fine word for this sentence.
Matt and Baby Bear sit by a tree. What do you want to do? Asks Baby Bear. Matt sees a monkey in a tree. Let's swing like monkeys, says Matt. Matt and Baby Bear swing in the trees. End.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Green.
A very proper choice of a word.
The trees end here, says Matt. What do you want to do? Baby Bear sees a snake in the green grass. Let's slither like snakes, says Baby Bear. Matt and Baby Bear slither along the ground. Rocks.
I say, what a good word.
Crawl.
That's it!
The grass stops here, says Baby Bear. What do you want to do? Matt sees a spider on the rocks. Let's crawl like spiders, says Matt. Matt and Baby Bear crawl on their hands and knees. Sky.
A fine word for this sentence.
Fly.
Right!
The rocks stop here, says Matt. Now what? Baby Bear sees a bird in the sky. Let's fly like birds, says Baby Bear. Matt and Baby Bear flap their arms. They fly to the river. Sort of. Splash! Next time, let's swim like fish, says Matt.
Nice work! I'm so glad you're here to help choose the right words.
Picnic.
A very proper choice of a word.
Each.
I say, what a good word to use.
Today is Matt's picnic, and I can't wait. Everyone is coming, so don't be late. Bring a picnic basket, but watch what you pack. For this picnic, please put cheese in each snack. Like.
That's it!
Else.
Excellent choice! Excellent!
Which cheese do you like? Maybe cheddar? Is Munster okay? Or is Swiss better? Yum! Cheese sandwiches. What else did you bring? That three cheese salad will make Maddie sing. Pizza.
Right!
Eat.
A very proper choice of a word.
Here's some cheese pizza. Do you want cottage cheese? Take as much as you like. Eat as much as you please. Are you having fun? Have you filled your belly? If you said no, eat some cream cheese and jelly. Under. Beneath.
A fine word for this sentence.
Getting.
I say, what a good word to use.
I'm so glad you came. Wait, I just felt a raindrop. The clouds are getting darker. Will we have to stop? No way. Come join Matt beneath her mouse umbrella. The rain won't stop us. Try the fried mozzarella.
Oh, we've done it. Here's the final script we need for the show!
We have everything we need from here. Let's check the list to see what we still need.
Excellent job, Rita. We're all done here. Now, go back to the theater to find out what else needs to be done.
Right, Professor. I'm on my way.
Ta-ta!
Maybe we should check the stage to see what we need. Or we can go visit someone else.
Just a few more things. We're almost there. These are scripts. A script is like a book of what the actors say on stage. You never see scripts on stage because the actors have to memorize what's in them. These are the special things that the actors made for tonight's performance. When you see the show, make sure you look for these things.
Where to next? Just